When electric current is passed through a liquid, a chemical reaction takes place. So it is said to cause a chemical effect. For example of a chemical effect, when electricity is passed through electrodes in acidified water, the water decomposes into the two elements it's made of, oxygen and hydrogen. Water, electricity passes through it, producing hydrogen and oxygen. The chemical decomposition of acidified water into hydrogen and oxygen caused by an electric current passing through it is called electrolysis. In 1800, William Nicholson, a British chemist, showed that when electric current is passed through acidified water, bubbles of oxygen gas and hydrogen gas are produced at the two electrodes. And here you can see the bubbles forming. Oxygen gas bubbles form at the anode, that's the positive electrode. Hydrogen gas bubbles form at the cathode, that's the negative electrode. There are a lot of bubbles at the cathode because for every one molecule of oxygen, there are two of hydrogen, H2O. Once again, how I remember this is that anode is positive. Therefore, everything good is connected to it. And since oxygen is important to us, it's obviously at the anode. But now let me explain the actual reason. You saw that in each water molecule, there are two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, H2O. And at the atomic level, this is how they are bonded. The electrons of both the hydrogen atoms are shared with the electrons on the oxygen to form the bond. You can see the electrons remain more with the oxygen atom and end up giving it a negative charge while leaving the hydrogen with a positive charge. This way, the water molecules have a negative charge on one side and a positive charge on the other side, and therefore it is neutral in charge. Once electricity is passed, an oxidation reaction takes place where hydrogen atom loses electrons and is left with a positive charge, so it heads to the cathode. Oxygen, on the other hand, undergoes a reduction reaction where it gains electrons and acquires a negative charge and therefore heads to the anode. Also note that the chemical effects occur not only when passing electricity through conducting liquid solutions, but also when currents go through molten compounds that conduct electricity. Chemical effects are of three types. 1. Bubbles of a gas or gases may be formed on the electrodes. 2. Deposit of metals may be formed on the electrodes. 3. Changes in color may be formed in the solution. The causes for these different effects depend upon 1. Nature of the conducting solutions or electrolytes through which the electric current is passed. And 2. The nature of electrodes that is used to pass the electric current. Let me show you all three effects. I'll start with the first cause, the nature of the electrolyte. See here, bubbles are forming. In this one, I will set up the experiment such that the circuit travels through a potato. A potato will also conduct electricity, as most fruits and vegetables have a lot of liquids containing salts or acids in them. I am using two copper strips as the electrodes. And we'll keep this in for 30 minutes. We can see the color changing around the anode. This change of color happened on the anode because some material from the anode starts leaving it, and in a perfectly conducting solution, it will get deposited on the cathode. Here you can see that the metal is being deposited on the cathode, and this we'll explore more in the DIY. Now let's explore some applications of these chemical effects. It is used for example, electroplating metals and even plastics, for purification of metals, for production of certain metals from the ores, also for production of chemical compounds, and it's used for decomposition of chemical compounds. I'll explain all of these a bit more, but the most common one is electroplating, and let's explore that more, and we'll also make it in the DIY as well. Electroplating is self-explanatory. Electro is where electric current is involved. Plating is when a thin layer of metal covers another material, mostly metal. Therefore, electroplating is the process of depositing a thin layer of metal over another metal object by passing an electric current through the electrolytic solution it is dipped in. Electroplating could either be done to protect a metal that would otherwise rust easily, like steel parts of bikes and taps, which are plated with chromium, and we call it chrome plating. Or it could be done just for decorative purposes to make it appear like something else. And that's done a lot in jewelry. A solid silver or gold object would be very expensive. Therefore, there's a huge industry of inexpensive jewelry that still looks like the real thing, because gold and silver and chrome can all be plated over cheaper metals like steel. So you can buy jewelry or watches that are gold plated or silver plated, or utensils that are copper plated. Visually, there's absolutely no difference, and many people are fooled and sometimes cheated by it as well. While electroplating, using this example of copper plating, the following is important. The metal which will be the coating or the plating or the final top surface needs to be the anode and therefore connected to the positive terminal of the battery. We saw that in the potato, the color had started spreading from the anode. The metal which needs to be coated needs to be the cathode, therefore connected to the negative terminal of the battery. For best results, a water-soluble salt of the same metal that has to be deposited should be used as the electrolyte or the solution in which the reaction will take place. So for copper plating, the solution should be copper sulfate solution that contains copper ions which start moving to the negative cathode when the electricity is passed through it. An equal amount of copper from the anode that was made of copper plate gets dissolved in the solution to replace the copper ions that were lost from the solution because of the deposition on the key. Purification of metals. If you notice in the process of electroplating, the anode always gives away the ions and as a result it keeps getting thinner because it is shedding layer after layer. So if there's an impure copper plate as the anode and you put a pure copper sheet as the cathode, pure copper is being deposited on the cathode while the impurities get mixed in the solution. Some jewelers use this technique to make your old silver and gold jewelry look shiny and new while it sheds a couple of layers into the electrolyte, leaving your jewelry nice and shiny looking. But if they are untrusted ones, they can easily take away much more than what's required, and visually the difference is so little that you'll never be able to tell. But to them, across thousands of customers, they get a sizable amount of dissolved precious metals that they can use for plating other metals. Production of metals. The chemical effects of electric currents are used to produce or extract some metals from the ores. Ores are naturally existing compounds where the metal is not pure. Chemically reactive metals like sodium and aluminium are produced by passing electric currents through their compounds like sodium chloride and aluminium oxide in their molten states. The required metals will get deposited on the cathode. Production of compounds. The chemical effects of electric currents are used to produce compounds like sodium hydroxide from an aqueous solution of sodium chloride. Decomposition of compounds. The chemical effects of electric currents can be used to decompose chemical compounds like water, for example, when electricity is passed through it. Water decomposes into oxygen at the anode and hydrogen at the cathode. We had done this earlier with iron nails and it worked perfectly. And just for fun, I'm using carbon rods as the electrodes. On the cathode, we can see a lot of bubbles, but on the side of the anode, a lot of carbon starts leaving the anode, but because of the divider, it can't get to the cathode. And it's trapped on this side. But I'm sure you've noticed that there are a lot more bubbles on the cathode than on the anode. That's because for every oxygen bubble, there are two bubbles of hydrogen because it's water, H2O. Two atoms of H and one atom of O. Now let's do a recap before we move on to the DIY of the lesson. When electric current is passed through a liquid, a chemical reaction takes place. So it's said to have a chemical effect. Chemical decomposition of acidified water into hydrogen and oxygen caused by an electric current passing through it is called electrolysis. William Nicholson, a British chemist, showed that when electric current is passed through acidified water, bubbles of oxygen gas and hydrogen gas are produced at the two electrodes. Oxygen gas bubbles form at the anode, that's the positive electrode. Hydrogen gas bubbles form at the cathode, that's the negative electrode. There are a lot more bubbles at the cathode because for every one molecule of oxygen, there are two of hydrogen, H2O. Chemical effects also occur when electric currents go through molten compounds, that's melted materials, that conduct electricity. The chemical effects are of three types. 1. Bubbles of a gas or gases may be formed at the electrodes. 2. Deposit of metals may be formed at the electrodes. 3. Changes in color may be formed in the solution. The causes for these different effects depend upon 1. Nature of the conducting solution or electrolytes through which the electric current is passed. 2. Nature of the electrodes used to pass the electric current. Applications of these chemical effects: electroplating metals and even plastics, purification of metals, production of certain metals from the ores, production of chemical compounds, decomposition of chemical compounds. While electroplating, we observe the following. The metal which will be the coating needs to be the anode. The metal which needs to be coated needs to be the cathode. Ideally, a water-soluble salt of the same metal that has to be deposited should be used as the electrolyte. An equal amount of metal from the anode gets dissolved in the solution to replace the ions lost from the solution. In this DIY for electroplating, I will copperplate a dog. Not a real one, this one. You can even choose a key or any other metal object to do this experiment. Earlier in the lesson when we did copper plating, we used copper sulfate to make the electrolyte solution so that it has a lot of copper ions to help the process of electroplating. But let me show you a simple way of creating the electrolyte without using copper sulfate. This time we'll use a bigger glass. So first we need to lengthen the legs of our cute little animal structure. We need two pipes of 7 cm each. These should be as the same diameter as the ones that are used in the structure. We'll replace the small legs with these long legs. I'm sure some of you must be thinking, why is it not that easy to become tall in real life as well? Now that the glass fits easily, I can proceed to explain how to do this experiment. Mix 2 or 3 spoonfuls of baking soda in the distilled water to make it a good conductor of electricity. Now you need some small copper sheet or a copper pipe or a copper plate, whatever you can find or buy from a hardware store. Put the bigger one at the anode and a small piece of copper at the cathode. Switch on the power. It's best to use the battery eliminator because otherwise the batteries will keep dying while doing this experiment. But if you don't have an eliminator, then use a total of 6 or 9 volt batteries. Leave it on for 30 to 45 minutes and you will see that the color changes from clear liquid to a blue liquid because now it has copper ions floating in it. If you increase the power to 12 volts, it is better to remove the bulb and connect the circuit directly without the bulb. Now that the electrolyte is ready, I'll first try with a stainless steel spoon. Apparently, stainless steel doesn't get plated very easily, especially not with such a basic setup. I'll try it anyway so that you don't have to waste your time doing it and you can see what the problem is. Remember to stir the solution once in a while. After 10 minutes, we take it out. You can see the spoon does get the coating, but if I wipe it, then the coating comes off. Some coating does seem to be left behind, so let us try a few more layers. But once again, when I wiped it, especially with a dishwashing scrub, the full coating started coming off. Stainless steel is a failure. Let's try something that is known to get coated well, iron nail. Hang it with a copper wire so that it gets dipped in the solution. And stir the solution well. Do the same process of coating it for 10 minutes and then take it out and wipe it to remove any copper that is not bonding to the metal properly. This time I'm wearing gloves because the nail is small and my hand will keep getting wet because of the solution. The spoon had a long handle, so it wasn't much of an issue. After two times of coating and cleaning, you can see the copper coat has come nicely on the iron nail. Let's do it one last time. This time you can wash it in water and scrub it. But don't scrub too hard, just enough to remove those loose particles. Now compare it with the original nail. Now before we copper plate the dog, we need to clean up the anode and the solution a bit. The anode has a coating of light blue with oxidation and we can use a sandpaper and water to scrape it off. But for now we can also use the other side by just turning it upside down. It is also important to remove the light blue sediment and the floating froth from the glass. You can do it with a spoon and also with tissues. This is the dog we will plate in copper. You can choose your object, but let it be a metal one that is not already painted or plated. It should be raw. Make sure there is a wire connecting the object to the negative terminal so that it becomes the cathode. Stir it once in a while. Remove the object. Clean the object. Then repeat the process. With the dog, we repeated the cycle 4 times and that's why it has come out quite perfect. Some places it still didn't plate well, like near his ears, because there was still some zinc plating there and we couldn't clean it properly. This was from the earlier time we had plated the same dog with zinc. In fact, zinc is easier to plate, and in case you want to try that out as well, this is what I had done earlier and it's on the channel. The link will be in the description of this lesson. You can also follow that DIY and see how to zinc plate nails and other metal objects as well. The ingredients will change, but the process remains the same. Things required for the DIY project: PVC structure from the previous lesson, PVC pipes, 2 numbers, 7 cm long, large drinking glass, baking soda, 2 or 3 tablespoons should be good enough, big copper strip or pipe, small copper pipe, stainless steel spoon, glass rod or any stirring rod, tissues or cloth, copper wire and nail, gloves or surgical gloves, raw iron or steel object that you want to copper plate, scrub pad and water in a bowl. With all this learning in this lesson, I'm sure you're transformed like these electroplated objects. In the next, we move on to explore about natural phenomenon. See you there.